The Honorable Defence Minister of India has played a pivotal role in strengthening our national security and advancing strategic interest. His leadership has been instrumental in shaping important defence policies. It's now a great privilege to invite Honorable Defence Minister of India to deliver a special address.
Thank you very much. Theru M.K. Stalin, Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. Theru L. Murugan, Minister of State, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, and Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs. Theru Durai Murugan, Minister for Water Resources Department, Tamil Nadu. Theru Shivdash Meena, Chief Secretary, Tamil Nadu. Trimati Rita Harish Thakkar, Secretary, Public Department, Tamil Nadu. Respected public representatives, senior officials, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. On this occasion, first of all, I would like to request all, on the occasion of birth centenary of Kalaginar, Theru Karunanidhi, I would request all of you to give standing homage to one of the greatest Indian and greatest great leader. Thank you very much. Brothers and sisters, Vadakkam. It is with great honor and deep respect that I stand before you today to celebrate the birth centenary of one of the most revered leaders of our country, Kalainar Karunanidhi. I pay my homage to Kalainar on his special occasion, a man whose influence extended far beyond the borders of Tamil Nadu, and Theru Karunanidhi was a titan of Indian politics, a cultural stalwart, and a relentless advocate of the social justice. Friends, as we gather here to celebrate his life and legacy, it is just imperative to recognize that his contribution to public good was not limited to Tamil Nadu, but also benefited the entire nation. His vision and actions encapsulated what it means to be Indian, a fusion of diverse identities, a commitment to inclusivity, and an unwavering dedication to democracy and progress. Friends, Theru Karunanidhi's political journey is a story of resilience, determination, and a deep-rooted connection with the people. His tenure as the five-time Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu is marked by his remarkable ability to address the needs of the common people. While navigating the complex waters of Indian politics, he was not just a regional leader, but a national figure whose influence was felt across the country. While deeply rooted in Tamil Nadu identity, Theru Karunanidhi never allowed regionalism to undermine the unity of India. He understood that the strength of Indian democracy lies in its ability to accommodate diverse voices and identities, and his participation in national politics, his role in coalition governments, and his interactions with leaders across the political spectrum reflected his commitment to the idea of India, a nation where diversity is celebrated. Friends, Theru Karunanidhi's advocacy for federalism was rooted in his understanding of India's unity in diversity, which I just described. He recognized that the strength of Indian democracy lies in its ability to accommodate different voices, cultures, and identities. His insistence on state rights was a call for a more balanced and equitable distribution of power within the union. Friends, this commitment to federalism is a key aspect of Indianness, and India's diversity is its strength, and the federal structure allows this diversity to flourish within a unified framework. Thiru Karunanidhi's work in this area ensured that Tamil Nadu's voice was heard at the national level while also contributing to the strengthening of India's federal structure. His legacy reminds us that Indianness is about respecting and celebrating our differences while working together for the common good. Friends, Thiru M. Karunanidhi was a legendary figure in Indian politics. He emerged as a leader in the 1960s, a period of major transition in post-independence India. Those were the days when several regional parties emerged and even merged to form the government. From Punjab to Tamil Nadu, this trend was very much evident. In many North Indian states, Sanyukta Vidhayak Dal, SVD, governments were formed, while many regional parties that emerged during that time have vanished. Karunanidhi, he provided such a strong foundation to DMK that it remains the only regional party of 1960s, continuing to hold power even today. Friends, India has celebrated its 78th Independence Day this year. Not many people know that before 1973, only the governor used to voice the national flag on Independence Day and the Republic Day in the state. Thiru Karunanidhi raised his voice against this and demanded that the chief minister should be allowed to voice the tricolor on national days. His voice had an impact, and it was decided that only the chief minister would hoist the flag on Independence Day. In this way, Thiru Karunanidhi also became the first chief minister of Tamil Nadu who hoisted the flag on 15th August 1974. Friends, he was a leader who deeply believed in the democratic process. He played a crucial role in shaping the political landscape of Tamil Nadu and India. His role in national governance and his advocacy for democratic principles have left an indelible mark on Indian democracy. Friends, one of the key aspects of his contribution to Indian democracy was his ability to work with diverse political ideologies. His ability to bring together different political parties to form stable governments is a reflection of the pluralistic nature of Indian democracy. Friends, I shall recall one incident. When Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji led NDA government was in power at the center and DMK was in alliance with the BJP, I was also a part of that government as cabinet minister for surface transport. Despite ideological differences, Thiru Karunanidhi ji played a constructive and positive role in supporting the Vajpayee government. His support was crucial. I would like to mention here, his support was crucial on issues of national importance and during significant events. There was one such event when the WTO Seattle conference was being held in 1999. Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji wanted that India's interests should be protected at all cost. DMK's Thiru Muraswali Maran was the commerce minister at that point of time. Atal ji had a word with Thiru Karunanidhi ji, and he ensured that India's stand was strongly represented. The Seattle conference was a success from India's point of view. Friends, throughout his career, Thiru Karunanidhi ji maintained a strong relationship with national leaders from various political parties. His ability to work with leaders across the political spectrum while remaining true to his principles is a testament to his statesmanship. These relationships were not just about political alliances, but were rooted in mutual respect for each other's contributions to the nation. Friends, the inclusive nature of Indian identity is reflected in Thiru Karunanidhi's policies. Whether in education, where he worked tirelessly to provide access to quality education for the marginalized, or in his efforts to ensure that women and children received the support they needed to thrive, Thiru Karunanidhi's vision was always of an inclusive society. He was a fierce advocate for the rights of women and marginalized communities, pioneered reforms that promoted gender equality and empowered women, leaving an indelible mark on the social fabric of Tamil Nadu. His government enacted legislation providing 33% reservation for women in local bodies. And he was instrumental in forming women self-help groups. First in Dharampuri during his regime in 1989 with the objective of empowering women. He also played a key role in creating welfare boards for workers in the unorganized sector, including agricultural laborers and transgender individuals. His work serves as a reminder that the true measure of a nation's progress lies in how to treat its most vulnerable citizens. Friends, he was an able administrator. He started a program called Manu Nidhi Thittam. Under this initiative, he had ordered the district official to reserve one day every week only to listen to the problems of the people. Establishing a direct and deep connection with the people is something that every politician should learn from him. Friends, one of the most significant aspects of Thiru Karunanidhi's tenure as Chief Minister was his focus on education and infrastructure development. He believed that these were the pillars upon which the future of Tamil Nadu and indeed India would be built. But Thiru Karunanidhi's vision was not confined to Tamil Nadu alone. He recognized that the progress of any one state contributed to the progress of the nation as a whole. His efforts in building infrastructure, whether in the form of roads, bridges, or public amenities, were aimed at creating a Tamil Nadu that could bolster India's march toward development. Thiru Karunanidhi's work in this area is a testament to the Indian spirit of self-reliance and progress. His belief in the power of education and infrastructure to transform lives aligns with the national vision of building a strong, self-sufficient and self-reliant India. His legacy in this regard is a reminder that regional development is integral to national development and that the prosperity of each state contributes to the overall prosperity of the nation. It best exemplifies the idea of cooperative federalism. Friends, Kalainar influenced extended far beyond the realm of politics. He was a prolific writer, poet, and a playwright whose works enriched Tamil literature and cinema. His contributions to Tamil literature and cinema have left an indelible mark on the cultural landscape of Tamil Nadu and India as a whole. Friends, his efforts to promote the Tamil language and culture were rooted in his belief that the preserving and celebrating one's cultural identity is essential to the broader Indian identity. India as a nation is blessing with a diversity of languages, cultures and traditions. Thirukarunanidhi recognizes that each aspect of this diversity contributes to the richness of this great nation. Friends, Thirukarunanidhi fought for democracy and dedicated his life to bring positive changes. The NDA government under Prime Minister Modi also believes in the power of democracy and that cooperative federalism. India is not only fulfilling the aspirations of its 1.4 billion people, but it is also providing hope to the people that democracy delivers development and empowers people. Friends, at this juncture, I also want to emphasize that our commitment for development is beyond partisan politics. The decision of the Government of India to establish defense industrial corridors, both in Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, is a case in point. These corridors are aimed at boosting the domestic defense manufacturing sector and reducing reliance on imports. These corridors are designed to attract investment, foster innovation and create a robust ecosystem for defense production in India. Friends, since I belong to the ancient city of Kashi or the modern day Varanasi, or you can say Banaras, I also want to highlight the initiative of Kashi Tamil Sangamam and towards the cultural integration of India. Prime Minister Modi inaugurated the Kashi Tamil Sangamam, a significant initiative aimed at rediscovering, reaffirming, and celebrating the enduring connections between Tamil people and Kashi. And have spent centuries building on the success of the Kashi Tamil Sangamam, the government has extended its commitment to cultural integration by launching the Saurashtra Tamil Sangamam. This initiative seeks to celebrate the cultural integration between West India and South India. Friends, as we reflect on the life and legacy of Thiru M. Karunanidhi, it is important to consider the lessons that the future generations can learn from his examples. One of the key lessons that young Indians can draw from Thiru Karunanidhi's life is the importance of staying true to own values. He never wavered in his belief that every citizen, regardless of their background, deserved the opportunity to live in life of dignity, which best exemplifies the great Indian culture and tradition. This unwavering commitment to his values is a hallmark of his leadership and a lesson that remains as relevant today as it was during his time. Friends, unveiling the Kalainar Thiru M. Karunanidhi coin, it is a tribute to the life dedicated to progress, justice and a betterment of society. It serves as a symbol of our collective gratitude and a reminder of the values he championed. Friends, with these words, I would like to conclude my speech. I am grateful to the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Thiru M. K. Stalinji, and the state government for inviting me to this event. I once again offer my heartfelt tributes to Kalainar Karunanidhi, and his life and contribution to public life will always be remembered. Thank you very much. Nanari. Thank you.
Thank you for your insightful address, sir.
சிறப்பு விருந்தினர்களுக்கு இவ்விழாவில் வெளியிடப்பட்ட முத்தமிழறிஞர் கலைஞர் நினைவு நாணய வடிவமைப்பிலான நினைவு பரிசு வழங்கப்பட உள்ளது. மாண்புமிகு ஒன்றிய பாதுகாப்புத்துறை அமைச்சர் அவர்களுக்கு மாண்புமிகு தமிழ்நாடு முதலமைச்சர் அவர்கள் நினைவு பரிசு வழங்கி சிறப்பிப்பார்கள்.
கலைஞரின் உருவம் குறித்த 100 ரூபாய் நாணயத்தை மத்திய பாதுகாப்புத்துறை அமைச்சர் ராஜ்நாத் சிங் வெளியிட்டார். அதன் காட்சிகளை நாம் பார்த்தோம்.
மரபுமிகு தமிழ்நாடு முதலமைச்சர் அவர்களுக்கு மதிப்பிற்குரிய தமிழ்நாடு அரசின் தலைமை செயலாளர் அவர்கள் நினைவு பரிசு வழங்கி சிறப்பிப்பார்கள்.
Now, felicitation to our Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu by the Chief Secretary, Government of Tamil Nadu with the memento.
மாண்புமிகு ஒன்றிய தகவல் ஒளிபரப்பு நாடாளுமன்ற விவகாரங்களுக்கான இணை அமைச்சர் அவர்களுக்கு நினைவு பரிசு வழங்கி சிறப்பிக்கப்பட உள்ளது.
Now, felicitation to Honorable Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting and Parliamentary Affairs by the Chief Secretary.
மாண்புமிகு நீர்வளத்துறை அமைச்சர் அவர்களுக்கும் நினைவு பரிசு வழங்கி சிறப்பிக்கப்பட உள்ளது.
Felicitation to Honorable Minister for Water Resources by the Chief Secretary with the memento.
நன்றி. மதிப்பிற்குரிய தமிழ்நாடு அரசின் தலைமைச் செயலாளர் அவர்களை நன்றி உரையாற்ற அன்புடன் அழைக்கிறோம்.
தமிழகத்தின் தனிக்கரை இல்லா தலைவர் கலைஞர் அவர்களின் நூற்றாண்டு விழா கொண்டாட்டங்களில் முத்தாய்ப்பான நாளான இன்றைய தினத்தில் நினைவு நாணயம் வெளியிட்ட விழாவில் கலந்து கொண்டு விழா பெருரையாற்ற